So I just wanted to give a little context to the video you're about to watch. Typically when people climb Mount Whiteface, they use the blueberry ledge trail. It's probably the most popular trail. And the blueberry ledges kind of have a reputation of being a little sketchy by some, and other people think that they're really, you know, not that difficult at all. Depends who you talk to, but I'd watched a few videos and decided that since I was hiking it alone at 871 that I wanted to skip the blueberry ledges. So I started looking at my maps and trying to find a trail that I thought would be a little easier, and I noticed the Downes Brook trail, and it looked like a nice easy grade, a long hike, probably 12 plus miles round trip, but I thought maybe that'd be a good way to tackle it, and it looked like an interesting trail. So I did hike the trail. I ended up taking the Downes Brook trail, and it's a beautiful trail. Probably one of the only considerations is it has 10 river crossings, and when I did it, it was low water, so, you know, not a big deal, but it could potentially be pretty sketchy if you were trying to do it in, you know, higher water conditions. So as a result of it being a long hike, and also as a result of getting a late start, which is another whole story, but I won't get into that, I was a little pressed for time and didn't do a whole lot of filming, not as much as I would have liked. And then when I got to the summit, when I got to the ledges where the views were, it was pretty crowded, so I didn't do a whole lot of filming from there either. So as a side note, I just want to also mention that I climbed it with the Gaia app, and I noticed when I was on the summit ledges, I was looking at my app, and I noticed that the Gaia map did not have the true summit of Whiteface marked on it at all. And what it did note as the summit was actually the ledges. And I noticed, you know, where it said Mount Passer Conway, the elevation was under 4,000 feet. And it's at that point that I realized that it was just showing me the ledges and not the true summit. Fortunately, I had kind of the map etched in my mind, and I was able to find the true summit, no problem. But just if you're considering climbing Whiteface with the Gaia app, just beware that you need to tag the true summit, which is completely wooded. It's marked with a cairn, and the Gaia app is not marking the true summit. So just wanted to let you know that. So that all being said, let's get on with the video. This morning I'm on the Downes Brook Trail and my attempt to summit Mount Whiteface, number 46 on my 48 that I need. And it's a beautiful day, got a little bit of a late start. I was almost out of gas, so I had to take a detour and make sure I was gassed up before I started my hike. So I have about, I don't know, 11 or 12 miles round trip, I'm guessing, today. It's supposed to be pretty gradual with 10 water crossings. That should be interesting. And but it's supposed to be pretty gradual right up to the junction with the, I forget the name of the connector trail. I have it on the map, but from then on, I think it's maybe another mile to the summit. So we'll see how it goes. picking a short break to fuel up and get some water. We've done 9 of the 10 stream crossings so far, and through the trees I can see the ridge that we're going to be climbing. It's coming up pretty soon, and so far this has been a really, really mellow trail. Hardly any uphills at all. I'm sure I'm actually gaining elevation, but it's so subtle that you hardly even notice. It's a beautiful trail. Footing's good too, not a whole lot of rocks and roots. Stream crossings are a little tricky, just hopping across boulders, but I'm really careful and I have my trekking poles, so not so bad. And that's where we're going. On the Kate Sleeper Trail, in between Rollins Trail, I think it is, and Downes Brook Trail. It's about 8/10 of a mile. Really pretty trail. The woods are pretty. It's fairly flat. Not a lot of incline. And really nice. So it's actually... Okay, this is the Rollins Trail. For a second there, I thought it was Blueberry Ledge, but that goes that way. This goes up to Passaconway. Pretty close. So I'm just about back to the car, probably another, you know, 1/8 of a mile or so. And if I was to do this again, I think I might go for a shorter, harder route. This was, you know, pretty easy grade and everything, but damn, it's long. This seems longer than Liberty and Flume, which had, you know, a lot more up and down elevation and so forth. But it is hot and humid today, so that would, you know, make it a little more difficult. And I don't think I hydrated properly yesterday. I'm gonna have to work on that. But anyways, number 46 is in the books. Back. Number 46, Whiteface, in the books.